Minutes to the gentlelady from Wisconsin, the chief sponsor, one of the chief sponsors of the legislation, Ms. Moore.
Gentlelady from Wisconsin, recognized for 3 minutes.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and thank the gentleman from Virginia. I rise today in support of H.R. 3610, the Stop Exploitation Through Trafficking Act. Before I say anything, I just want to thank Congressman Erik Paulsen of Minnesota, who has been a tremendous, superb partner throughout the process of putting this legislation together. I want to thank the authors of all the other 4 bills that are going to be considered today. This bill really incentivizes states to put safe harbor laws into place. That's the crux of this bill. But I can tell you that solving the problem of sexual exploitation of children is going to require a lasting commitment and bipartisan effort. It is going to be very, very, very difficult, colleagues, because this, as the FBI has told us, is not just something that happens in Nigeria, but it's happening right here in the United States. It's a $9.5 billion annual business activity that 100,000 kids a year are currently trafficked. Another 200,000 are at risk, that a pimp can earn as much as $250,000 a year in this booming business. It's going to take all of us to stop this. The victims are mostly girls, and on average, they're trafficked at age 13. And I'm embarrassed and I regret to report that my own hometown of Milwaukee, Wisconsin, has become known as a sex trafficking hub for both children and adults. As a matter of fact, the FBI reports that Milwaukee has the second highest in the nation for recovered youth. But trafficking is now common in communities all across the country, not just urban, but suburban, rural, from coast to coast. Predators victimize vulnerable young people, such as those that my colleague from California, Congresswoman Bass, will talk about in the foster care system. They prey upon those who are in poverty, but they seek out higher income kids too, going after those who may have some problems at home. They are predators against those who are LGBTQ. The victimization happens on our streets as well as online. The traffickers are everywhere. And the consequences, social displacement, health issues, physical pain and disfigurement, infertility, PTSD, suicidal thoughts, and attempts. 13-year-old children need support and not incarceration. The Stop Exploitation Through Trafficking Act would alter our laws and our thinking about this, that minors are treated like victims rather than perpetrators of crime. They need direction and support for programs like the Job Corps rather than prosecution.
Madam Speaker, I yield the gentlelady an additional minute.
Gentlelady is recognized.
This legislation also officially establishes a national human trafficking hotline to help connect victims with the services that they need and allow others to pass along crime tips to law enforcement. This, I am so proud that this legislation has been amended to add trafficking victims to those eligible to receive Job Corps services, giving them access to job skills training that can lead them toward a better life. The Job Corps, a port in a very tumultuous storm. I will yield back my time because others may want to speak, but I'm so pleased to co-sponsor this legislation, and I would ask that all of my colleagues support its passage.
Gentlelady yields back her time. The gentleman from Virginia.
Madam Speaker, it's now my pleasure to yield 1 minute to the Majority Leader, the gentleman from Virginia, Mr. Cantor, and to thank him for his leadership.